Good evening, everyone. The webinar session is arranged about structural engineering companies and careers. Today, we have invited Sanjay Kushwaha, Vishwal Gupta, and Mohit Sharma as guest speakers. Sanjay Gupta is a structural engineer who is working in WASP, New Delhi. And Vishwal Gupta, he has 6 years of experience in design of long-span bridges, highway bridges, major and minor. He has completed his civil engineering degree in FET, Agra College, and he is working design engineer, project consulting India. And Mohit Sharma, he has a field experience in ballast track, semi-high speed rail track, design of viaducts, rail structure, interaction and dynamic analysis of bridges. He has completed his BE civil engineering program from Amity, Greater Noida. Currently, he is working as GCOMI director, Delhi, Agra. We welcome you for this webinar, sir. Kindly take over the session.
Thank you, sir, for the introduction. Before starting this, I would like to thank HOD ma'am and the college for giving us an opportunity to represent GCOMI in your college. Before starting this webinar, I will take 2 minutes to explain what is GCOMI. Then we will continue with the webinar. Okay, the question is, what is GCOMI? The meaning of GCOMI is Connect Me. GCOMI is a social network platform that connect college students to professionals for learning, advice, meeting, and job referrals. Same as like Facebook and LinkedIn. What problem we are solving with this platform? Why you need this platform? Students have lack of information about the industry. At present, if I'm talking about in civil engineering, there are so many fields like site engineering, structural design, town planning, traffic engineering, and so on. But how many students know about how to make a career in bridge design, highway design, in solar panel system design? So student has lack of information about the industry. And the second point is, then the reason is zero communication with professionals and alumni. Third point is, students are not skilled as per the requirement of the industry. And no mentor and advisor to guide them properly about their career. Zero exposure to practical knowledge, no information about the industrial practice and companies. Getting no response and reply on social network platform like LinkedIn from professionals. So many students try to communicate on LinkedIn, but the problem with LinkedIn that they did not get reply. And no platform where a student can clear their doubt. So we are solving this problem where we are connecting college students to professionals so that they can learn, they can work with them, and they can upgrade their skills and knowledge. Students spend their 4 years in colleges, but I think they have to spend few months in learning skills and working on practical projects. So this is a platform where they can learn with professionals on live projects. How you can learn from professionals on GCOMI? Okay, so this is a platform. This is the website of GCOMI. You have to simply search any technical topic related to your engineering. For example, if you want to learn STAD Pro, simply search STAD Pro on search tab, and you will find multiple profile. And you can filter those profile on the basis of their company name, college name, location. If I search like Louis Berger, I will get Vishal Gupta profile, and I can check Vishal Gupta profile. He has 6 years of experience in bridge engineering, and I can see the skills. You can check the education. You can check the experience of the professional person, whether he's right for your choice or not. You can check the activities of that particular person And the best part of this platform is that the activities are related to your project, related to your skills and knowledge. Even college students can create their own profile on this platform, and they can post the activities related to their project, related to their skills and related to their knowledge, and they can share the link of the profile to HR or companies. And how you can learn? Simply go to events. We are running 3 events right now: ETABS design, Brit design, and Revit structure. And these 3 events, if I'm talking about in terms of money, we are charging a very less fees as compared to like training institute or any institution. Like in, if I'm talking about ETABS, the fees of ETABS in AutoCAD Center is from like 8,000 to 15,000 rupees. And Brit design, first of all, no one is teaching Brit design. So if you really want to enter into a Brit design, you can join our program. And Revit structure, we are charging very less fees. So the aim of this platform is not charging too much. The aim of the platform is to connect college students to professionals so that they can upgrade their knowledge. So now let's begin with the webinar. Okay, the topic is what is structural engineering, how to enter in structural engineering, and so what is structural engineering? Structural engineering is about designing the structure which can resist design forces. It can be RCC structure, steel structure, wood structure. And the engineer who design such kind of a structure is known as a structural engineer. Okay, the question is, what is the scope of structural engineering? At present, we know that there are so many companies are shifting from China to India. And to accumulate all these changes, we need a good infrastructure in India, like bridges, highway, airport, and complexes. If I'm talking about budget, so in budget 2020, India government proposes like 103 trillion infrastructure project launched under NIP, presenting the Union Budget 2020 to 2021 in Parliament. Sita Raman said focus is on infrastructure for economic development, and they allotted 6,500 projects across sector under National Infrastructure Pipeline. So if I'm talking about government vision towards infrastructure, it is wide. So after 2 years or 3 years, the demand of good skilled engineer will be higher in highway design, bridge design, and RCC structure. The question is structural engineering a good career? Yes, it is a good career if I compare with other field of engineering, like site engineering job, surveying, and geotechnical engineering, even with a government job also, in terms of package. It's a 9-to-5 job, first of all. So if I compare with site job, so it's a MNC job. Okay, now question is, what is field in structural engineering? We all know about like building design, like RCC structure, we all know about. What about bridge design, highway design, how to enter into town planning, how to enter into traffic planning? So I will explain the building design because I have a 5 years of experience in building design, and I will share my experience, how I started my career in this field. So after passing out in 2015, I struggled to find out where I have to apply as a fresher to get a job in this field. And finally, I got up one company and I did my intensive 6 months. And after completing my internship, still I'm struggling because no one is guiding me. No one is mentoring me where to apply as a fresher, because the problem after completing the college is that companies are not hiring freshers. They are looking for a skilled graduates. And on that time, I know only StatPro. And I think that StatPro is the sufficient software to get a job. But when I enter into industry, then I realize that StatPro is no one is using right now. Everyone is using ETABS software in building designs. Even Burj Khalifa is designed on ETAP software because the software is easy to handle and easy to learn. So that's why each and every company all over the world is using ETAP software. Finally, after like completing 1 year, I realized there are so many MNCs which are providing a good salary package. So finally, right now, I am working for a WSP India, and it is a leading company in the world. and they have head office in Bangalore and Noida. So in building design, if I'm talking about softwares, so ETAP software required for structural engineer and Revit software also. And in steel structure buildings, ETAP, StratPro, and Tekla are the basic requirement to enter into this field. And the third field is pre-stressing structure. If I'm talking about pre-tensing and post-tensing, so we are using Adopt, Concise Beam, and Win Static software. So these are the three fields. These are the wide three fields in building designs. So if you want to enter into this field, you have to choose your path. Look, for example, if you want to start your career in RCC design, then you have to learn ETAP software and Revit software. And so many students learn AutoCAD software. Let me tell you one thing about AutoCAD software. Right now, none of the company is working on AutoCAD. So every company is working on Revit software. So if you are wasting your money and time, the best part of Tekla software is that we directly get the output of drawings. We do not need an AutoCAD software to design any beam on AutoCAD software.
So I'll start with my very short presentation. So basically, I'm a civil engineer also. And this platform, as Sanjay told us, Jikumi. So I'll explain this platform in very well, very short line. This platform is for civil engineers and by the civil engineers. So I'll start with my career. I passed out in 2016 and I started a job and I got campus placed in an interior designing firm. And after 6 months, I started my career as a site engineer. And after 6 months, I got confused and started my career as a structure designer. So there's no wise me or on a project of India's first regional rapid transit system with designed the field of railway. So I'm in track and bridge. And if I talked about the software we use, we are using ETABS for the building and StatPro for the analysis thing. And for the tunnel, we are using OSIS software. For bridge part, we are using Maida Civil. So I'll show you a video, very short video of hardly a minute of basically what I am doing in Tekla Structures. So Tekla Structure is a BIM modeling software, but I am using Tekla Structure for reinforcement detailing. So I'll share a video. Is that visible?
Yeah, it is visible.
Okay, thank you.
That was visible, but
yeah. So this is a bridge on which I am working. This is a simply supported box girder. You can see a segment of 3 meter, which are joined using post tensioning cables. So I'll just start the video. So basically what I am showing in this video is the level of detailing. These all are the details. Let me just, these are the spherical bearing using first time in India. These are the pedestal. And if I show you the reinforcement part. So basically this is the reinforcement part. You can see the level of detailing. If I define level of detailing in numbers, it is 500, which is the maximum. So basically we are using this software for drawing as well as before casting it to the site. We know the error which can be came. So with this software, with the help of class check, these errors can be checked before the site. Just you can see that this reinforcement is clashing with this reinforcement. So this is just very basic video I'm showing you. Basically, if I talked about specifically about this seminar only, Sanjay, you can share your display. If I talked about this seminar only, so basically it all depends on you. What do you want to do about your career or your interest? If your interest is in building only, then you should go for ETAPS. You have to go for ETAPS, I should say. if you're interested in track, if I say about track design, it is a field which I think no one knows. We are using ballastless track in India for the first time. So ballastless track is also using metro, but we are using slab track. So if you are interested in bridge design, go for MIDAS. If you're interested in building, go for ETABS. So that's why we are here for you. And not only us, whole platform is for you. You just need to know about what do you want to do. Or if you are confused like me, I was very confused. I even don't know what to do. I want to be a site engineer as well as I want to be a track engineer. So I just say that this platform is just to help you, just to guide you.
Yes, so what happened, student has a lot of questions in BTech, like which software they have to learn first. Okay, is MTech is okay or not? Okay, we have to go for higher studies or not? Okay, we have to prepare for government job or not? Okay, let's learn AutoCAD. We will get a, let's learn some. So some students think that AutoCAD, they will learn AutoCAD and they will get a job. And because students
yes,
in BTech,
even I have spent almost 25,000 rupees in learning AutoCAD and StatPro software after my graduation. So
yes, I know that so many students are like going to AutoCAD center and they are learning AutoCAD software they're charging 8,000 rupees for that. And like same for StatPro. But in current situation, if I'm talking about for engineer, we are not using AutoCAD. We are not using StatPro in building designs. Some companies are using, local companies are using StatPro, but only for analysis purposes, not for design purposes. So you have to guys understand that. You guys have to understand that there are so many fields in civil engineering, and each and every field have their own requirements.
Own
like if I'm already, I already told you that in RCC we need ETAP software. In bridges, if I'm talking about, we need MIDAS software. If I'm talking about BIM, then we have a Tekla software and Zabbix software. So students are not aware about these software and they are just blindly follow StatPro, AutoCAD. So I have a request to all students.
And
you then, have to communicate with professionals.
Software. Yes, Sanjay, continue.
Yeah, the thing is that it's not only about software, first of all, to get a job.
Yeah, not only software, only in fact, the codes also.
Yes, exactly. You have to work with professionals to upgrade your skills and knowledge, not only related to software, but related to your technical parameter.
Also, yeah, like we are using IS-456 and during our college days, I am still using IS-456. But the thing is, if I am designing bridge for the railway, I am using IRS codes, Indian Railway Standard. Similarly, if I am designing bridge for the traffic, for the highway thing, we are using IRC codes, Indian Road Congress. So it depends also on your interest as well as the field for which structure we are, for which thing we are designing the structure. And if we talk about
bridge engineering, so Vishal will explain
bridge,
all about bridge design.
Structure, box girder. Sanjay, you are saying something?
Yeah, Vishal, can you please explain about bridge design and your experience in bridge engineering? Vishal?
Yeah, I'm audible.
Vishal has 6 years of experience and he's working in MNC company Lewis Berger.
Just a minute. Okay, so myself, Vishal, is the screen visible to you all?
No, Vishal, it's not.
Just a minute.
You are presenting, but I think we are unable to see.
Okay, I'll try once again. Not a problem.
Sorry to all of you. As this problem is coming, we all are at different places.
is it visible now?
Not yet, Vishal. We are just seeing ourselves on screen.
One second, I'm checking on my system.
No, Sanjay, it is completely fine. I think Vishal is only sharing his display. Vishal?
Okay, not a problem.
Sir, you might have minimized the presentation screen, I think.
Okay, I got it.
Yes, sir.
You would have chosen a display.
So, myself, Vishal, hi all. I would like to give a little bit basically knowledge about this bridge engineering industry across our civil engineers group. So basically, according to my own personal experience, what I feel, this is the most challenging field of civil engineering, in which if somebody tries to make their career, it is very good financial wise. Second thing, a very passionate job, I would say, because always there are very very tough type of scenario into your life, but you enjoy it also. So I would like to start, like, did you ever feel like passionate looking at some iconic structure? Like, do you ever feel like flow of forces into a structure, how forces flow from one element to another element, and then it finally goes into this foundation? So I feel that you can definitely become a bridge engineer. So as a fresher, I don't think you need very much knowledge for this this thing. You need a structural analysis knowledge, basic knowledge of your school, of your college basically, and understanding of flow of forces. Design of structure is not a very prerequisite into this. Visualization of drawing is very much important. What might you have learned in your this CAD classes? CAD classes, I mean this engineering drawing classes. And computer skills is more important. From computer skills, I would try to make 2 points. First is your basic software, not STAD Pro, but Midas, which is very much prerequisite, which has become prerequisite into our this bridge design industry. And from computer skill, a very good knowledge in working with Microsoft Excel. Because combining this software and Microsoft Excel, we used to design bridge in our industry. Okay, so this is I would like to share something about importance of bridge, like why bridges are so important, and they are an important part of Indian infrastructure. This you can see a picture which is known as a Chenab Bridge. It is the longest balance cantilever bridge in India. Indian project.
So yeah, that's exactly, Vishal. Because right now I'm working for New York region. So what exactly the model of MNC company in India, they hire Indians people at a very low cost, and they open their offices in India so that they will get a cheap labor.
Not low cost, I would say low cost according to them, but according to us it is good industry wise, means whatever you get paid, according to them it costs like low, but I'll come into that. Okay. So these are some list of Indian companies I would like to share, and these are list of some MNCs. I think Sanjay will tell you about this company. No, Sanjay?
Yeah, I will share.
Okay. So these are some types of bridges: beam bridges, arch bridges, and cable bridges. And these are some photos of the bridges, basically. And I would like to share something about this bridge component. Bridge has basically three parts: one deck, one bearing, and one this pier and pile foundation. So basically every component is designed independently into this bridge industry. So the basic knowledge I would like to share from all this thing, you can present, Sanjay, now. Okay. I would like,
you know, Vishal, you please share, please explain all about like upper structure and speed.
Okay, fine.
Oh, thank you, Vishal. Okay, why you choose bridge engineering? So basically the career growth in bridge engineering is really good as compared to like buildings and site engineering job. The challenge, you will face a lot of challenges because every bridge is a challenge. And third is good salary. And fourth is international exposure. Like Vishal work with Oman, Vishal work within Italy project. So you will get international exposure in bridge engineering. And what you require to be a bridge engineer? Simply a BTech. You have a good knowledge about software, Midas and STAD Pro. STAD Pro basic knowledge, but Midas, yes. Because this is a basic requirement to enter into bridge engineering is Midas software. And third point is technical knowledge of IRC code. Because we are designing bridges and highway from like on IRC codes. Like building we are designing by using IS456 code. But we are designing bridges by using IRS codes and good knowledge of structure analysis, steel and RCC. So this is the Midas software where we designed deck slab. This is a 3D view of the software. And this is a drawing which we are designing on Revit software. So every company is using Revit software, Tekla software for bridges. And if I'm talking about building, so we are using ETAP software, Tekla software. And if I'm talking about other field like tunnel engineering, some student think that you need M.Tech to enter into tunnel engineering, geotechnical engineering, environmental engineering, and core engineering, basically, I'm say. But it's a wrong MNC. There are so many MNCs in India. These are the MNCs, top MNC in India, like Ramboll, Atkin, Mott MacDonald, Arup. You can Google it. They hire fresher for these jobs. If I'm talking about like tunnel engineering, bridge design, hybrid design, and the salary package for fresher for B.Tech student is 3.2 to 4.2 lakh, and for M.Tech student 4.6 to 7.2 lakh. I'm talking about the freshers. You will not get such kind of a salary as a site engineering. Or if I'm talking about in government, if I compare with government job, then after 10 year, 20 year, like head, if I'm talking about my company head, he's earning crore. So the salary package, if I compare in terms of government job, yes, you will get a really good salary in private sector if you have a good technical knowledge and if you are really good in your core. Core means like, you know, tunnel engineering. Right now in India, there's a shortage of tunnel engineering. There's a shortage of environmental engineering. In environmental engineering, the part is your CBS system design, pipe network. Like town, if I'm talking about town planning, in town, we have to design a CBS system. So this is also a part of a civil engineering. And so one of my friend, he's working in environmental engineering as a CBS system design engineer. And he's working for Sudan company. So yes, you can make a career as a fresher in these companies. You just need to connect with professionals and the right person. Basically, I will say right person is the correct word. And if I'm talking about the local companies, TPCL, Wintech, these are the local companies in Delhi NCR. Majorly, all the design companies are in Delhi NCR. Some companies are in Bangalore. Some companies are in Chennai, Hyderabad, and Mumbai. So these are the reason where you can find a good company. So TPCL is a local consultant company in Delhi NCR, and they have the major projects all over. If I'm talking about all over India, so yes, you can apply in TPCL. They hire freshers every year. They hire freshers, and Wintech consultant, Siftech consultant, EDR, Manish consultant. These are the local companies. Even you can find in Bangalore also. You can just search. Such a structure consultant in Bangalore. You will find a lot of companies, local companies in Bangalore also. So if you have any question, guys, you can ask, then we will discuss further. Sir, can we get some question, please?
Yes, actually, there is a question from a participant.
Yes, sir.
Is Tekla software is recommended for structural engineers?
Basically, Tekla software is a BIM software. So I said that there are 100 profiles in civil engineering. So in which there's one profile called BIM engineering. So suppose if you learn Tekla software, then you have to find a job as a BIM engineer, building information modeling. So there are two software. One is Revit software and second one is Tekla software. So there is a huge requirement of Tekla software also and Revit software also. So you can make a good career in BIM also. So Tekla is basically a BIM building information modeling software. So if you want to make a career in a BIM software, you do not want to learn or code. You do not want to design technically. You are not interested in technical part. You are interested in drawing part. Then you can choose a BIM modeling career. And the salary is really good in BIM career. If I'm talking about Revit and BIM, the salary is really good as compared to same as engineer. Yes, sir.
The next question is, participant has requested StatPro and ETAS both are used to analysis for structures, which they can prefer.
Right now, if I'm talking in terms of globally, right now my company is using ETAP software, WSP I'm talking about, Ramboll. They are also using ETAP software. None of the company is using StatPro right now in buildings design. I'm talking about RCC structure, not specifically in bridges or steel structure. In buildings, yes, ETAP software you have to learn. But if you want to go for like steel structure design, so you have to learn StatPro. Because on StatPro, local companies still are using StatPro. So you have to choose your career accordingly and you have to choose your software accordingly. If you want to go into RCC structure, then go for ETAP software. If you want to enter into steel structure, then go for STAAD Pro, and for ETABS also, because both software are using in steel structures.
And the next question is, can you please specify any two software which is mainly used in BIM or in lean structures?
I already said that in BIM we are using Revit software and Tekla software. So Tekla and Revit software both are majorly using in buildings, bridges, and all kind of infrastructures. And if I'm talking about like other field like pre-engineering building, like solar system design engineering, they are using STAAD Pro.
Is Revit architecture is good enough for taking part in BIM?
Revit architecture is basically for architectural, not for structural engineer. So you have to learn Revit structure.
Is MEP is much important for civil engineers?
No, mechanical engineering and plumbing is a part of a mechanical department, not for civil engineers.
Okay, so the questions are over.
But yes, like plumbing, if I'm talking about, it's a part of civil engineering. And there's one more field in this MEP is your environmental, basically, to reduce the cost of building, to make the building in eco-friendly. So there are some software which like my company are using to optimize the like I'm talking about in terms of energy. So yes, you can also go for it. Yes, sir. Any questions?
No, Sanjay.
Okay, sir. So
yeah.
So this is the website link right now, ss.jacomi.com. We are not live right now. We are working in a closed model. But next year, Jan 2021, we will launch publicly. And you can find other features on our platform like alumni portal. You can find your college alumni on our website easily. And the second important feature is meeting. Suppose if you want to meet me, you can easily book a meeting with me. It can be a call, it can be a message, it can be a physical meeting. Third is job portal. We are going to integrate a job portal on our website where you can easily find a job, and you can even talk to HR also. And the fourth one is book. So you can create your book. For example, you can create your RCC book, you can add chapter on it, and you can write question and anyone can answer. So basically, we are going to make a book of question and answer of any particular topic. So I'm just going to again tell you. So right now we are teaching three softwares, structure analysis, bridge, and Revit structures. We are going to add STAAD Pro also. If you are interested, we can add one more professional who's expert. They can teach you STAAD Pro also. So this is all about Jacomi and career and companies in structural engineering. Just search a structural consultant in Bangalore. You can easily find like these are the structural consultant in Bangalore. The motive and the aim of this platform and this webinar is that please guys learn from professionals, people. Please do not pay to any training institute or AutoCAD center. Do not waste your time with them. It's better to learn from professional people who are working in the industry. If you want to be a structural engineer, then learn from a structural engineer. If you want to be a site engineer, then learn from site engineer. It's up to you. If you want to make your career in tunnel engineering, to learn from those people who are in tunnel engineering, because they will guide you. I cannot guide you about bridge engineering. Vishal can help you to be a bridge engineer. And there are so many MNC companies in India. I'm again share the screen. You can take a snap or you can Google it. They hire freshers every year. These are the MNC company. They hire freshers. My company WSP India, they always, every year they conduct walk-in interview for freshers, graduate. And what they required, the requirement is simple, software knowledge and technical parameter. These are the two requirements to enter into the industry. And the infrastructure in terms, if I'm talking about infrastructure of the MNC is really good. They pay you well, they will take care of you, and they will pay you for the overtime also. So thank you so much, sir. This is all about Jacomi, and career and companies in structural engineering. Thank you so much, sir, for your time.
Yeah, sure. Thank you for your session. It was very informative and useful. On behalf of Department of Civil Engineering, KPRIIT, I thank Sanjay, Vishal Gupta and Mohit for their information shared over here. Definitely, it will be helpful for students to identify the software which they need to study in future. Thank you.
And
thank
guys, you if you have any question, you can just join this event. We already created your college event. You can just go to discussion part and you can create your question and we will answer you. If you have any question related to your career, like if you want to go for an M.Tech or not, because what happened right now, I did my AbiTech, but I did not complete my M.Tech. So parallelly, I'm completing my M.Tech. So this is the best option. Get your job and do parallelly your M.Tech. So just simply create your new question and answer. We will reply on the same. Okay, guys. Thank you. Thank you so much, sir, for the time.
Thank you, Sanjay. Thank you.